na 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 yeah. Ah, wakanisa usingizi ni heavy, lala kwa ibada kama mlevi.
We need to acquaint ourselves with God so that we can start to operate at the dimension of the peace of God. The Bible says, acquaint yourself now with God and be at peace, therefore shall good come to you. But how do we get this good? I had a message the Lord had given me the other day, and I've been meditating on it. So when I was called to minister, I ministered that message. But today I'm doing it at a different level. And the Lord told me today we are supposed to break everything that has held us to a stagnation. And the greatest stagnation, the greatest battle that you have is the battle of words. The battle of words. I know today there are people here who are still suffering the same suffering your relatives suffer. Why? Because of the voice of the prophecy of the people. If you don't know how to negate it, you suffer the same suffering of your relatives, the same suffering of your cousins, the same suffering that has been going on. Because why? People will keep on prophesying. Do you allow the name? Acquaint thyself with him and be at peace. Thereby will good come to you. Verse 22. Receiving his instructions from his mouth and lay up his word in your heart. Keep it there. We'll see what happens when you do that. A lot of the battles that you're fighting today are not your own. Some battles are cycles that have been there over and over and over before. Why? Because there are people who claim this is in this name that you have been named. How are to our and they never get married. You get what I'm saying? And so generations gone, generations present have spoken everybody named after so and so, they can never marry. And if they marry, they cannot sustain a home. Is it true or not? And we have agreed. How many times have you students said that is not my portion? They should say they don't marry. You say yes, but I will marry. Some have said in this family there are limitations, and the people have spoken, and you have joined them in speaking, and you have believed the lies of the devil. And today your life is revolving under the dimension of the lies of the enemy. And you have accepted that this is how it's supposed to be. And that's what the Bible says. Now you're struggling with an enemy that is too strong for you. Why? Because you have believed it and you have talked about it. You have meditated about it. And so it is. When you are still strong, you are told, how about you are somebody? So you began to meditate upon that. Verse 7, the Bible says, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. And you have believed it because you have heard it over and over and over and over, until now it repeats itself automatically. You don't even need anybody to remind you. It just plays in your mind. You are born and already you have heard your auntie say, all of us here are divorced. Auntie so-and-so was a divorcee. So-and-so is a divorcee. At a way of your life, it's a divorce. True or not true? Then the program in the mind has been, even when I get married, I will divorce. And so you become a divorcee. And today, I know there are people who are divorced. We are not blaming you. We are coming to change your story. Some people have been told, if your family has been able to progress. There is a lady who gave me a testimony. She told me there are 7 in their family, and none of them goes beyond class 2. Why? Because there has been a word spoken. There is a choice to make today. You can acquaint yourself with the standards of this world, or you can acquaint yourself with what God says, and she began have masters. Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Why? Because it takes a decision that God, this has been saying, but if I acquaint myself with God, my story then can change. I want us to go back to the book of John, chapter 22. Anytime you speak something that is not in line with God, it is counted by God as an iniquity. The situation political, but it is not about the situation, it is about you. As you think in your mind, so are you. You can be affected by whatever you want to affect you, and you can be above whatever you choose to be above. But it has to take a choice that I am not a failure. I'm going to acquaint myself with Jehovah. When everybody says there is famine, in famine I shall be laughing.
Yes.
Is that your portion? When everybody else says that I cannot prosper, you need to rise and say, I don't know about them. But what I know, I am the head and I am not the tail.
Amen.
I shall prosper whether there is business in the market or not business. My business is come from heaven. I think I was running on a lot of pressure. And so I had a lot of symptoms telling me, will you make it to church? Hi, I told my body, listen, I am acquainting myself with Jehovah.
Yes.
I am not acquainting myself with what you say. I am acquainting myself with what he says about me. Praise the name of Jesus. Church of God, you've got to start acquainting your children with the Lord. Tell your child you are above only and never ever below. Let their mind and their meditation be on the things of God. Can I hear you say an amen?
Amen.
I know some of us, you need to pray today and tell God, believe my mind. Clean it up again. The strongholds that face us today are from us, not from Satan. Satan is your own mouth. And if you didn't say it to your mouth, you said it to your heart. And you didn't mention a woman. Yeah, just you. Our family don't do these businesses. I'm a hippie. Job. We don't. There's some words I was trained when I started serving in ministry. When I started serving in ministry, I was serving under Bishop Olutayo, Winner's Chapel. And I remember there's a time Bishop Oyedepo was coming to town. That time we were just a skeleton staff. We were very few. And I was given a machine. I was told you need to photocopy. Because you are doing a lot of photocopies. I have never seen a photocopy in here. You don't know operating it. I've never even seen it in here. You know I'm a villager. But I came to town by marriage. Praise the Lord. So, here I've come from the village because I was not married. And I'm given a big photocopier. And the pastor tells me we need 500 copies. I'm left with dreams of paper. I don't know what, but I know I always see a light passing like this when you're photocopying. How the light happens, I don't know. So I told him, you know what, that time you were in Pastor Lafish. I told him to, man of God, me, I don't know how to do it. He told me, you know what? Words like I don't know should never be in your mouth. Why? Because you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. And that changed my mind. My friend, papers were achieved. But finally, I made very nice copies. Praise the Lord. And today we are telling every mountain from our mind fall down in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every mountain in my heart. Why? Because the word impossibility only exists in the heart of people who are afraid.
Amen.
To try. Today you tell me to discuss on any topic that I don't even know. I'll never tell you, I don't know. Now give an own church. I was telling a few people in one of the international organizations, when I was told to go and train on pitching of business, I asked myself, what do you mean by pitching? And I told them, I said, are you serious? This is my topic. They told me, yes, you're training us on pitching and you're also training on what and what and what. I told myself, you know what? I'm going to pitch. I'm going to train to pitch. I didn't even know which that I passed. But by the time I was done, I knew I will never tell them I cannot do it. Church of God, your rising comes when you begin to become a solution. Nobody needs a person who is part of the problem. You've got to start thinking big to yourself. And I tell people, nobody will ever touch you for speaking big to yourself. It is not humility to say, we will have some pity on you. But you not in the evening. Are we together? We don't need to look for pity. We don't need to look for affirmation from anybody. If God has told you that he'll give you a solution on how to clear the sewage and the garbage, tell God I receive it, because the Bible says I have the mind of Christ. Church of God, you've got to start thinking like the people who have the mind of Christ. Say amen.
Amen.
Never say die.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
I meditate on greatness, and you have seen nothing yet. That is mine. You know, nobody will take me to God for speaking my words. Hallelujah. Sometime back when we had a case in court, we were suing somebody who had a lot of influence in the government. Talk of influence, it was influence. And when I sat with one of the sons of one of the very influential people, he told me, Roger, you cannot be able to go far with this case. I told you, not even going far, it is to topple this man down. And guess what? Not by power, not by might, but by his spirit. God did it. Why? It is not by power, it is not by spirit, by my flesh, but by his spirit. We've got to start clearing clutter from our brain. You are told when you are young and you still believe that you are not beautiful. You've got to wait for a man to tell you you are beautiful. If nobody tells you, talk to the mirror and tell, mirror, mirror on the wall, who is the most beautiful? Of course it has to be me, I'm full of his glory.
Amen.
Or who is the most handsome? We have conformed so much to the standards of the world that we need an affirmation even to step out. People will tell you, I want to do this business. Is it okay? I don't know. I don't know what you and God have spoken. If you, in your heart, you are at peace, go on. Praise the name of Jesus. I don't know what you spoke with God, but church, I want to dare you today. Begin to rise up above the step, the level that you have laid for too long. Can you begin to rise up? Say, I will rise up. Has been your heart. And the devil puts fear in your heart. Why? Because he shows you all the negatives, he shows you all the impossibilities, he shows you how easily you will fail. But my question is always this: not what if you try and fail, what about if I try and succeed? Amen. Can you dare to reach out to another level? God is saying, when you begin to acquit, wealth becomes your portion. You don't just give it in account, you give it and sow it beyond many waters. That's my business slogan. Psalms chapter 1. Whatsoever a righteous man doeth, it shall prosper.
Amen.
Do you believe that? Or do you start from the foundation of fear and failure? We've got to start acquainting our minds with God. You're a student. You have been told in your life nobody has ever passed maths. Even your parents and even you told your children. We don't pass in sciences. But who said so? The Bible tells me that God blessed Daniel with all understanding of sciences and all literature. That means I can be a well-rounded student. The more you lay in your head, you need to wake up and go to that business. And tell this business, this is the smallest level you'll be my business. This is the smallest level you will be, this one. This is the smallest. From now I prophesy to you greatness.
Amen.
Are we together? Start getting your paycheck. Tell your paycheck, this is the smallest I've ever been paid. I prophesy to you multiplication. Why? Because in my heart I know I am not this size. Even if I give you half a million, tell God thank you, but this is not my size. In my heart I know my body is beyond the ceiling.
Amen.
You know, I'm getting a paycheck of 50,000. I have to be at home and dress so that. Now listen to yourself. Or you made a small breakthrough, got yourself half a million. And I'm not saying that small money. 50,000 is not small money. Even 100 shillings is not small money. Are we together? But what do you think when you get money? I was telling some people. When everybody is broke, they are very humble. So be quiet. That's a good amount, yeah. That's a good amount. In case of which, I am a person. Everybody wants. They are very humble because their hearts have been controlled by money. Are we together? They come for prayers when they are broke. In fact, the kind of prayers they pray, you even think that heaven is coming down for them. Baba Songa, Baba Nitembele, Baka Sauti Naishi. You see some ominous, you on fire. Lakini na uliza swali, Nitembele, and you pray the same. Tuko pamoja. Mungu akikutembelea, because he's a God that answers prayers. Na uliko naomba. Divino, inaitwa nini? Unakata hiyo divino. Hivi tu, unasema mama, it is written in our mouth, it is written in our mouth. Twist until a few shillings enter your wallet. Oh, you're going for prayer. Please remember me in your prayers. Please remember me in your prayers. You know, I know the intercessors are praying. Jesus prayed in John 17 for us. So that one can keep me going, which one? We've got to move to dimensions beyond yourself. The Bible says he shall bless us to be a blessing to the nations. You in your own village, how many people have you blessed? Now let us start there. In your house. In your house. Like before you get to the village. He told Abraham, I've called you to be a blessing to the nations. I want to ask you a question. How many people have you blessed in your house? And already you are thinking, because now I've been able now to settle the level of my house, I'm okay. Then how many have you educated beyond your house? How many? How many times have you landed to the nations? I was passing through this route of water this morning, and the road is so bad. But I thought you should be landing to the county council. Lambia again in Tama. Now who can afford? And you're here feeling to my feet. And to Jafika, Bonaiso, Sikiwe. Who feel that is a small state of our hearts. Until you can tell them, first of all, come to church and pray. And I need you born again. Then I can give you a check to help Pastor mark the road. Like in Kwanza Wongo. Now, if you're Konga, Ukuja, Ujazo, Naro. County Council, Nakuja, prayer morning. When you do that, it's not that you obey your God. People don't even obey your God because they know you owe them. Najua ile mtu wa maziwa. Mtu wa maziwa hapo kiosk. Mtu wa ndizi. to everywhere. And when you tell them my God is a great God, I'm not saying it's wrong to our own, but today we're changing the story.
Amen.
Are we together? For now you can wake up and say, I'm going to borrow from now, but I will lend to the nations. I am acquitting myself with God, and thereby being at peace. What do you do about all the words that you have spoken that have held us down today? Jeremiah chapter 23 and verse 29. Jeremiah 23, 29. Hallelujah. Is not my word like a fire, says the Lord, and like a hammer that breaks the rock in pieces? So today we're going to speak the word of God of our situations. And that word of God will begin to burn foundations. There are foundations that were spoken against you. But if you tell the word of God, come and you go. Because words were spoken and today they are bearing fruit. Because the Bible says in Proverbs, life and death is in the power of the tongue, and they shall eat the fruit of it thereby. Today perhaps you are eating that fruit, but we can tell God by your word it is written. And I choose to believe you, Lord, that I will leave this place with a new mindset. And it is a mindset of being more than an overcomer. Say amen. Some people are bound by small things. Oh, you know, for me it is this pornography, it is masturbation, it is what? Start renewing your heart to the word of God. Renew yourself with the word of God. The things I told you captive are holding you captive by choice. It's a choice. Why are you not held captive by the good things of life? Like scriptures. I'm such a captive of scriptures. I wish you could be saying that. I'm such a captive of the word of God. But you find yourself, why? Because you feed the wrong things in your life. Whatever you feed is what begins to grow. And that is what controls you. I want us to stay.